Public health officials in Michigan have encountered a rare piece of good news when it comes to PFAS. Kelly House covered the story for Bridge Michigan.
For some fish species, including smelt from the Great Lakes, PFAS levels are actually lower than public health officials previously thought.
PFAS stands for per- and polyfluorinated substances. It's been widely used in non-stick, stain-resistant, and waterproof products.
The bad thing about these chemicals is that they do not readily break down in the environment. So that's earned them this nickname, forever chemicals. They're linked to things like cancer, immune system breakdowns, hormonal problems, high cholesterol, even reduced vaccine response.
Due to the high level of PFAS found in Lake Superior smelt, the state of Michigan had issued an advisory not to eat more than one serving of the fish per month.
When these really high readings were showing up in Lake Superior smelt, public health officials acknowledged that it was weird. These smelt weren't swimming in waters with any known PFAS contamination nearby. So it seemed strange for them to be showing up with these really high levels when no other nearby fish were showing similar problems.
After conducting new tests, scientists discovered that a naturally occurring bile in smelt had been interfering with the results.
It has characteristics that show up on testing as PFAS. So it was artificially making these test results appear as if PFAS levels were sky high when in fact they weren't. State officials are now going through hundreds of past fish samples to retest them using a method that works around this bile issue. The original testing method were showing PFAS levels in the hundreds of parts per billion. Now, it's more like the teens or even the single digits.
And it's not just smelt affected by the new findings.
I saw results for sunfish, for rock bass, and for smelt, all of which essentially showed the same thing. Original test results showing really high PFAS levels, and the new test results showing dramatically lower levels.
Kelly says that despite new information, the state is holding off on changing its advisory until it knows more.
Just because there's less PFAS in the fish doesn't necessarily mean it's safe to eat more fish. State officials basically say they need more time to digest this information, and they will likely be changing fish consumption recommendations when they release the state's new annual guidance this year.